Well, we're just excited to find out who we play. Feel like we're back playing some of our better basketball, at least in the last 4 weeks or 5 weeks or so, more similar to how we played in December and early January. We seem to have maybe gotten our legs back and at least are in a little bit more of an attack mode on the offensive end than we were when we were going through that tough stretch. We've defended well enough. We've, for the most part, rebounded, well enough to put ourselves in a position to win. There's a little bit more spark on the offensive end than we had for some time, and that was good to see. We had to go on the road to Bradley and obviously beat Wichita in the final game to put ourselves in position to win that title. So couldn't be more proud of my team. And, we look forward to hopefully what's a great 3 days here.
We'll start with questions for Coach McDermott. As a reminder, please raise your hand, state your name and affiliation, and direct your question. Our microphone holders, Christy and Bethany, are on your flanks, so please raise your hand. On the right side, up front.
Chase Williams, CBS Omaha. Coach, sitting here with the end of the season, with everything that's happened, the awards that these guys have picked up, everything in perspective, how do you rank this season among some of the others that you've coached?
I've said this before. I think one of the hardest things to do in sport is to do what you're supposed to do, and able to achieve the expectations that are laid upon you. And we were picked to win the league, and we found a way to do it. I don't know what the numbers are, but I think my guess is somewhere around a third of the teams that were picked as their preseason conference champions are going to end up actually being conference champions. So it's much more difficult to be picked to win the league and win the league than it is to be picked to finish eighth and finish fourth. So in that regard, I'm very, very proud of what this group has accomplished, because we went through a really tough stretch and all the pressure was on us, and we found a way out of it. And that's a credit to these guys, and in particular, the guys up here that are our leaders on our basketball team. So it's been a very rewarding season. We hadn't won a championship at Creighton for a long time. So to be able to bring that back to Omaha is very gratifying.
Additional questions? And the front on the left.
Todd Golden, Tarot Tribune Star. Greg, you talked about the tough stretch you went through. What pulled you out, and what can you do as a coach to try to pull a team out of a tough stretch?
Well, our message was to stay the course and make sure that there were a lot of things in Omaha. When you have 18,000 fans at every game, you've got a lot of assistant coaches that have ideas when things go bad. And because of the internet and the power of the internet and Twitter and Facebook and everything, some of those things become prevalent in the social media. And it's hard to put blinders on to that. And our message to the team was, I don't care what's going on outside of our locker room. Inside our locker room, we're not going to point any fingers. We're not going to make any excuses. We have to get better. We have to do things better than we've been doing them, but we're going to do it together. And because this group is so close, I think that enabled us to dig our way out of it. Because I didn't ever really see in a practice or in a situation, in a team situation, where these guys began to turn on each other or question, what we were asking them to do. And, again, that's a credit to their character and the way they were able to fight through that.
Question all the way in the back.
Coach Thortrip from ABC in Omaha. Do you guys have a preference in terms of the style of play you'd like to see in this first-round matchup, and then also just a little bit about each team, what you've seen from them so far this year?
I've watched a lot of film of both, obviously, and one minute I want to play Drake, the next one I want to play Bradley. So I think they both certainly have some strengths. Obviously, Drake really put it on us in the first half in Des Moines, and we were able to dig out of it and make it a game late. And then not quite be able to finish it. Drake's got so many people that can shoot the basketball. Really, oftentimes have four guys that can shoot the three-point shot on the floor, and they spread you out. I think they're a little bit deeper than Bradley, perhaps. But on the other hand, Bradley, I think Walt Lemon Jr. and Dyrika Sims-Edwards are maybe the best guard duo in our league. So I think there's strengths on both sides, and really I don't care who we play. I want to know who we play so we can get to work on it and, you know, spend some time in the ballroom tonight walking through some things to make sure these guys are ready at noon tomorrow.
Another question for Coach McDermott before we move to the student athletes up front on the right.
You have to make sure you win the first game, so it doesn't make any difference the second game if you don't win the first one. So our substitution pattern won't be any different unless the game would dictate otherwise. We'll play the first one and see how it goes. And the reality of it is we have not gone very hard this week in practice. My guess is their legs are feeling as good as they have in some time. Because we've really tried to back off to get ourselves ready for this weekend.
Coach, Doug has a shot to become Creighton's all-time leading scorer this weekend. What would that mean to see him accomplish something like that at this university?
Yeah, it'll mean more when the season's over and you look back on it. And, it's nice to have your players accomplish some individual goals and have individual awards. It's much more satisfying when that's done when your team is really successful. And I'm confident Doug feels the same way. It'll be a great honor and something that 15 years from now you look back on and realize how special it is. But what makes it special is that it's part of a very good team and a very good season.
We have another question up front on the left.
Jim Benson of Bloomington Pantograph. Greg, with all the chatter being revved up pretty hot and heavy, it seems like, especially today, about the new league. Are you worried at all about that becoming a distraction this weekend?
Myself, my staff, and my team is not on the need-to-know list, so there's no chatter going on with us because we know nothing. And there's a lot of people that have known me a long time would agree with that I know nothing. So, but we haven't been let in on that. Obviously, the chatter's out there, but it's not going to won't impact our preparation.
We'll move to questions for the student athletes.